Hello and welcome to week 2, video 5 of the SAS Bootcamp. In this video, we are going to learn about how to delete columns. Just like deleting rows, there are multiple ways to do it, and it's usually fairly simple to understand how to do this. Now, there are two primary SAS commands you need to know to understand how to delete columns. The first one is the drop command. The drop command tells SAS which variables to drop or delete. The second way command is the keep command. The keep command tells SAS which variables to keep or which variables to not delete, basically. So let's write a quick example and see what this will look like. I'm going to create a new data step. I'm going to write a new data set. I'm going to call my new data set boats underscore fewer columns, because this is the same data set boats, but it's going to have fewer columns in it. I'm going to set my class, write my set statement with the boats dataset and the class library. And there's my run statement. Let's first write the drop command. Now, if you will recollect, the boats dataset actually has 5 columns: name, price, port, locomotion, and type. So let me delete 3 of those columns. I'm going to drop the port variable, the locomotion variable, and the type variable. And the only way to specify all 3 is to just write a simple space between them. So I'm going to hit run here. Check my log. Log looks okay. And here's my output data set, right? It has just 2 columns, the name column and the price column. Port, locomotion, and type have actually been deleted from my data set, which is exactly what I want. Now, the other way to do this is to use the keep command. Let's say I use the keep command and list the same 3 variables. I'm going to comment out the drop command because I don't want both of them in my code for now. I want SAS just to read the keep command. I hit execute. Check my log, which looks okay. Open my output data set. And now you will see that my output data set just has 3 columns: the port column, the locomotion column, and the type column. So the name and the price columns have been deleted because keep did the exact opposite of the drop command. Which one should you use, drop or keep? Well, that's completely up to you. If you are, for example, deleting only 2 columns, then it may be easier to just use the drop command. If you are keeping only 2 columns, then use the keep option. So really, which command you use to delete columns in your data set depends on how many variables you want to drop and how many variables you want to hold on to at the end of your data step. Either one should create the same output, so it really does not make a difference. Now, having said that, your drop and keep commands do not have to be included within your data step, and there are ways to include them as options, and that can actually change how the data step is processed by SAS, and it can make your program more or less efficient in some cases. So let's look at an example. So instead of using my drop and keep commands within the data step, I can actually write them right in my data statement right here. So in my data statement, drop and keep are valid options you can include. So if you want to include these options, finish your data statement like you usually would, write the name of the new data set, and then write enter a space. But before you type in your semicolon, add 2 parentheses, and in between that, add your drop command. Now, when you use a drop command in that option, you have to follow it up with an equal symbol. Without this equal symbol, SAS will throw you an error because that's not a recognized syntax. But if I use the equal symbol and I type port, locomotion, and type, it should give me the same exact output. My log looks okay. And in my output, you'll see I only have 2 columns, name and price. Now, if I come here, you'll see that the type word is actually in blue. Please don't get confused by that. It is happening because type is a variable name, but type is also an option you can use in your data statement. But as long as you don't follow that type with an equal symbol, SAS understands that you are referring to a variable. You're not actually referring to a different option. So this drop option within the data step does the same exact thing as drop if I were to write it after my set statement and before my run statement. And if I wanted, I could replace the drop with the keep, and it would do the same thing the keep option did earlier. Let's check my log. Log looks okay. And look at that output. This time it kept the 3 variables. It retained port, locomotion, and type, and it did not keep or it deleted name and price of the boat. So drop and keep statements work similarly whether they are between set and run or whether they are added as an option for my data statement. But there is actually a third way you can drop or keep variables in SAS. And in that way, you actually do the you actually add it as an option, not on the data statement, but on the set statement. And the syntax for doing so looks exactly like adding it as an option in the data statement. So in your set statement, you will list your input data set after the library name and the data set name. And then within parentheses, you basically say drop equals list of all the variables you can drop, or keep equals list of all the variables you want to keep. So let's run this with the keep command added as an option to the set statement. Log looks okay. Output, there you go. It has only retained the three variables we are looking for, just like the keep command elsewhere. And if I replace the keep here with drop, you will see that it should do the same exact thing as you would expect. It will drop those three variables. Log looks okay. Output data set, it dropped port, locomotion, and type. So we are left with name and price. Now, quick note before we wrap up this video. Drop and keep as options on the set and data statements actually are different from including it in between the set and the run statements. In fact, probably the most advantageous thing you can do is include these drop and keep statements within your set statement. The reason it is valuable to do that is because that actually can save your computer's resources. Let's say you are dealing with a file that has 30 million rows and it is a file that is about 1 terabyte in size. So you're dealing with a large data set and you're working on a computer that's struggling to keep up with the size of this file. Well, one thing you can do to make your processing go a little more faster and a little smoother is to actually drop the columns you do not need in that data set within your set statement. Because when you drop variables within the set statement, the SAS program data vector doesn't even read in those columns before it starts compiling the program. So if it is not reading in those columns, it needs less memory in order to be able to process it, which means you are saving processing time and your program actually runs a little bit faster. So if you want to be efficient with your programming, use your drop or keep statements as an option on the set statement. Just remember that if you do that, and if you drop certain variables in your set statement, then you can't actually use those variables within your data set in order to do variable manipulation, whether that is creating a new variable or manipulating those variables in any other way. As long as you drop them in the set statement, they are not even read into your data statement. That concludes deleting columns. We'll pick up in the next video where we will talk about manipulating character variables.